We are here talking to actor Prakash Rai, who has an opinion and a question to ask everyone. Let's start with the recent development that has happened. A case has been filed against you by the BJP for using derogatory comments against Modi. How do you respond to this?
They have complained to the Election Commission of India. How do you respond to crybabies? Okay, and it has to come out of proof. I don't use derogatory words. I'm asking questions of the promise they have made, and they need to answer. And if they're going to say, "Mummy, he's talking against us," be men enough, answer, let's have a dialogue. Do you think only you have the rights? You use derogatory words. Your president talks everybody as dogs, cats, that, this. People know that the Election Commission come. It's all there in politics when we fight. When they don't have answers, they'll go to mummy. I'm fine with it.
You've been touring the state, different district with different cities. What are you trying to do? What is Just Asking campaign?
Just Asking campaign, in connection, in this present scenario of elections, I'm going to try them and tell them, don't forget things. Because all politicians, especially BJP things, you know, they divert issues from an issue to issue, and they think people have very small memory. I'm doing this job of reminding them of the promises they made and asking them to ask questions on development, not to seek votes on religion, because it is very important that how important for a citizen it is, you know, it's not just elections. Once you have elected this representative, every second, the representatives, the policy decisions the representative take will affect every second of your life. So you're politically in it. And this is what I'm trying to explain it to them. People are listening because the truth in Karnataka was such a strong voice with clarity was not there. So this voice is bringing out the voices in them and they're questioning, and I'm seeing people understanding what I'm trying to say.
But the one allegation against you is that you only question the BJP and not the Congress.
Yes, I've been very clear about it. I have the more, of all the politicians, I have the one who has got more clarity as a citizen of this country. Because I feel and I believe the ideology of BJP is dangerous to this country. So I'll talk against them. Not that I'm supporting any other party, but then I have to bring the big guy who's dangerous to this country down first. And then I'll continue to ask questions. And the people believe me that I'm going to ask questions later or two.
And to the Prime Minister, what are your questions?
Dear Prime Minister, please answer my questions. What happened to what you had promised? You talked about a future. The country gave you a mandate that you're talking about the future. The last 3.5 years, you have not delivered, and we are asking you a question. Why are you going back to the past? A very simple talk. What, see, Narendra Modi ji came yesterday to Bangalore, to Karnataka. The same old thing. Who is Rahul Gandhi, dynasty, politics, blah, blah, blah. How many times will you talk about it? What is Rahul Gandhi's age? What's your age? What's his experience? What's your experience? You have been a chief minister. You have the prime minister too. He is growing. So you want to prove your credentials by talking against him? Or will you say what you have done? There's no answer. You don't want to answer our questions as a common man, as a citizen of this country. You are answerable. You are accountable.
Why are you personally attacking Prime Minister Ismini? What do you ask?
I am not attacking him personally. Am I talking about his holidays? Am I talking about his personal religion? Am I talking about his food habits? I am talking about his work. I am talking about what he promised. I have voted. I have every right to ask. He is supposed to answer that. But your people are asking personal. They are worried about why my mother is a Christian. They think I am anti-Hindu, which I am not. They are talking about why you are an actor, why you are talking. When you guys came to vote, did you come to me as an actor or as a citizen of this country? You are making it personal. I am not making it personal. I have every right in this country as a citizen to ask my Prime Minister, what happened to what you promised?
You've been talking a lot of politics. The natural question for many is that, are you going to enter politics?
I am in politics already. I am the politician already. Being in politics does not mean you should be in a party. You should have your own party. You should be an MLA. You should be an MP. The very fact a citizen is politically aware, he is in the politics of this country. and I am a citizen, and I am aware of my political consciousness, and I am asking with that consciousness. I am in politics.
But you are an actor. What changed? What made you political now?
I am an actor too. I am a citizen. I am a human being. When this much of wrong is being done, when so much of lies have been told, I have woken up. I have realized my right, and I am asking this question. I may be late, but you can't question me, oh, you are asking me just because you are late now.
But why won't you join a political party? If you want to make a political change, isn't joining a political party, you won't even start one.
I have thought about it. I have thought about it. Should I start a party? Should I be an MLA? Should I be an MP? Then I pondered over it. And I realized what is the problem in this country is the political awareness among the people, because we, the people, are the majority. And the team which comes to me, the friends we sat and discussed, and they said, Prakash, you are right. What is important in this politics today is to empower the citizens to realize their right and come together and question and be a pressure point for any party or any representative to be answerable and to be accountable. And I believe that is the way forward. Fair enough. I have my way to be in politics.
The murder of Gauri Lankesh changed you?
It shook me. Everything happens when something happens very close to you. Something will change you. There will be a metamorphosis. There will be an evolution. When the killing was at my doorstep, a 35-year-old friend. I mean, that was the journey we have had. And more than that, we are all influenced and groomed by a fantastic political editor, a great writer, a great thinker called Lankesh, her father. And to know that whom I know has been silenced, whom I know can kill and get away. It is to instill fear on people. I felt that she is asking me, Prakash, have you left me alone? Isn't your responsibility? Am I the only one to ask questions? I said, yes. I woke up. I should ask questions. I should say, Gauri is gone. That wound is deeper than flesh. Nothing can get me back that joy. But then at least I can stop further Gauris. Isn't that the responsibility? Let us be possible. Let's look ahead.
It's been close to a year since her murder, or assassination as many call it. Are you the only one remembering her now? Do you think so? Are the others who have been inspired to fight after her death?
There have been too many people who are inspired to fight. The way where I go, the people who come, the people who support me. It is not just Gauri. It is not just friends of Gauri. A common man who is not connected to Gauri is realizing voices is being silenced. The way the people, the BJP and all those people celebrates, even till date in Karnataka, they are writing articles in the BJP papers. They still have hatred towards her. You can have hatred, you can have difference of opinion, you can't kill. You can't rejoice a murder, you can't, that is not our society. People know it, people have realized it, yes. They have seen me as an actor. They have seen me as a social worker. I've been an open book to them. I've lived with them. I'm in the mindset of the last 25 years, 2.5 decades. And when I raise a question, they know what I have left to come and do this. They will understand my honesty. How much ever you try to tarnish me, how much ever you do it. And what are the answers these BJP guys or this Bucks doing on social media? I have a photograph of me and my wife in a swimming pool, in a resort. And they say he is with another woman. It's my right to be with my wife. What have they got to do with my mother is a Christian? Why are they bringing all those things? People are watching. People had no problem issues about that before that.
Let's talk about Karnataka politics, Karnataka elections that's coming up right now. How do you look at it? You are saying BJP is not an option for Karnatakas, but do you think Congress is an option?
BJP is not an option for this country itself. Forget Karnataka. See, it is not that I'm supporting Congress. See, we can't be just cribbing about all parties, though they have weaknesses. First, bring down who is dangerous to this country. First, bring down who is silencing your voice first. Know your pawn, flex your muscles as a thought process. Then get assured that you can bring them out and threaten the next government that we will bring you down to. We are not going to take it anymore, the citizens of this country. Whoever comes, we will question. We will hold you. I will.
But are you now?
I have decided when to question. It is this another 10-15 days of elections. I know, I am clear who has to be come down first. You can doubt. You have every right, because people like me have come and gone in this country who have promised people that we will question. They have not. So you please have your doubt. Keep me on the edge. See me the way I behave. That's after 12 days. After the results of the Congress government or any government which comes. I'm going to ask them too. You trust me once you realize with my action, with my activities, with my pursuance, with my commitment to the cause. Please, you should doubt. You should doubt. Just because Prakash Raj is a good actor, just because he has adopted two villages, don't accept me. Let me work. Let me prove. Because if I am going to say now, you are not going to believe.
There is still time to win. So what if Prakash Rai turned into a politician or a political person only for the elections? Then what?
You will know it. I am going to lose name what I have got now. I am a little sensitive guy. I know. Why will I throw away whatever I have gained in my life?
So what is at stake for you?
Nothing. I am more enriched. I have more power. I have more purpose in my life. See, human beings, as they grow, we evolve. And this is another way of evolving. I was a small actor. I was a theatre actor, then a television actor, then a film actor, across languages, a director, a producer, a columnist, a social worker. Now, politically aware, I am doing something. I listen to my heart. I listen to what my sensibilities tell me. You know, to evolve, to be different in life. It's good. To multitask.
In India, in the current political system, do you think we are living in a fascist state as claimed by many?
It's not claimed by many. It is told, expressed by people who are suffering it. Isn't it? Anybody can get away, fringe groups can get away. Elected governments, mandated governments, BJP can go against Supreme Court. See, the problem is bringing BJP down in Karnataka is not the point. What you should be worried about is the growing doubt, the growing mistrust in people that has judiciary in somebody's hands. Is election commission in somebody's hand? Is the income tax? I have a doubt. In Karnataka state, there was a case against Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Jayalalitha ji. They said that she was wrong. It was shifted to Supreme Court. A judgment comes. It's in a cover. Because it is reserved, she goes on to become the Chief Minister of a state. Becomes an aide. Then she has a sad demise. Then there's another person, Shashikala, who comes down. We see Modi going and blessing her. And just because she did not hear her, the governor is removed from there for 2 days. Till the judgment comes and the cover is opened. And she is put behind bars. Now, how could 8 months back, if the judgment was there in the cover, how did you let somebody who is accused win an election and run as a chief minister? We don't know who did it, but this has happened. You should be worried about that in this country. You should be really worried about that country when 4 judges come out and speaking. You should be really worried about that. Shouldn't you be worried about that as a citizen of this country?
Aren't you worried about the fact that in this system it could affect you, your career as an actor, your life? Aren't you afraid of that?
I am rich enough to lose. Richness of a person should be, you know, measured with how much he can afford to lose, not how much he can afford to amass and be safe in his life. You are looking out of some money being lost. I'm happy. I have homes. I'm not a criminal to go behind bars. I'm asking a question. You may reduce some money coming into me. It's fine. I am rich enough to lose that. But when will you see how enriched I am too? How purposeful I am too? What honesty is giving me too? What fearless has been giving me too? I am walking with heads held up in the air. I am richer.
But your entire industry is being clamped down.
So what?
Have been banned.
So what?
How do you react to it? How do you respond to it?
Nobody is, you know, invincible. You go on. If I was working for 365 days, I'll reduce mine because I have my life to live. I'm not here to come some sevashram thing like that. Okay? They'll find another actor, yeah? There's another talent which will come up.
So the question is that are you against the Modi government, the BJP government, or are you against the idea of Hindutva? What are you against?
I am against this very fact of trying to force an ideology on us. Your religion should not be a government. Look at Pakistan. When a religion becomes a government, look at that state. Look at the poverty. Look at the unscientific thing. Look at the pressure, tension they are living. You want India to be like that? Do you want a country to be like that? Do you have examples? Look at Hitler. When he thought one race should live, look at the wounds he left back in this world. You are born to this world. You are a human being. Learn to live with differences. Look at a forest. There's a big tree and a small plant, and certain things go down, something grows down. Everything live in harmony. That's nature. Don't you take it. You are, after all, a human being. Don't be a parasite on this earth.
Will they come back to power?
Huh?
Will they come back to power?
No way. No way. See, in the history of mankind, anybody who's a fascist, anybody who was a dictator has not been a permanent structure, okay? They have lived. The tragedy is they have a very bad endings. But the pain, the wounds they live on, leave behind on civilization will take decades to survive. Human soul will survive, will find ways, will cry and get up. It's okay.
This entire political activism, is your acting career taken a hit because of that?
I'm acting right. What do you do? What do you want? I don't want to be called one just as an actor. Let me be known as somebody who made a difference. Somebody who... See, I have become a popular actor not just because of my talent. It is because of the contribution of the society too. It is because of their love, their acceptance too. No political party made me an actor. So when my society is in danger, when an actor like me, when an artist, the whole world, the history of the world, artists have come out as painters, as sculptors, as writers. They have come out as become an activist because it is their responsibility. If an actor, if an artist becomes covered, he is responsible for society to become a coward. We should realize that.
You've traveled across Karnataka so far. What is the pulse that you are getting from the ground up in the upcoming election?
I see people are waking up. And I'm very, very confident with all humility that my voice is making a difference. People are thinking, media is coming and covering it and taking to people. People just don't, Modiji comes and speaks. People nowadays just don't listen or judge a person by his speech anymore. They also see how they behave, and we have seen them the way they are behaving. So people are aware, and I'm very, very sure those sort of rhetorics will not work in Karnataka. Mr. Yogi ji has come, he has failed and gone back. I don't know what he'll come back and say, because after that they have known him, what he has lost his home ground there. He's not coming and talking about that he's with his mandate, the great development work he has done, and he's not talking about that. He's only talking about no Tipu Jayanti, do Hanuman Jayanti. Amit Shah has been questioned on Dalit issues. The farmers have asked, he has had no answers. He has left meetings. Modi ji has come. There has been a retort which is happening. It has never happened like this before in the Modi wave. People are seeing how he was sent back from Tamil Nadu.
You have been vocal against a lot of these leaders, Anand Kumar Hegde being one particular, who's filed cases against you as well, I suppose. The question is that why do you think people listen to them? He's still popular.
It happens. There is the amount of religion. There are innocent, there are ignorant people. They know how to drug them. How to tell them, turn issues, divert issues. It happens. See, people are beautiful because they are vulnerable. People will continue to be vulnerable. That's the most beautiful of it. I am worried about these people who are misusing that vulnerability, who are misusing that trust. I don't hate people. I want to stop a thought process which thinks it can get away making scapegoats of vulnerable, beautiful citizens of this country.
Some questions have come on live as well.
Please.
Rehana asks, the government cannot protect its women and support rapists on the other hand. How can you trust them going forward?
Please ask this question, lady. It is not just supporting rapists. What happened to the 33% reservation women reservation which has been in the last 4.5 years in this country? Even if you are a governor of this country, state, you can't touch my cheeks without my permission. The governor says, sorry, but a BJP guy says, she must have slept her way up, wash your hands in phenol. This is their attitude. Women, ask questions, please. We are not safe. Because they have that Manu Samskriti in their brain. They want women to be where they are. You please ask this question. This is the ideology they want, and this is exactly what I'm saying. This is exactly what I'm saying.
Another person says, Modi ji has been elected by the people. How is he a dictator?
So, if they have made a mistake, we don't have we will not get another chance to correct our mistakes. Just because you are vulnerable, you will hold us responsible, or will you hold yourself responsible for what you have not done? If majority is the truth, crow should be the national bird of this country. Every 5 years we have elections, we will decide again. We will say sorry to ourselves. Give us a chance. Why are you asking us not to ask questions?
And there are a lot of comments coming, you're speaking from your heart, etc. To those fans of yours, what do you have to say?
Be the citizens of this country. Don't look at me as an actor. Please try to understand the pain. I don't hate anybody. I am worried about the nation. I am worried about the society I am living in. I could have been in a comfort zone. I am in a comfort zone. I have wonderful farms, great houses. I have achieved. I have name. I can, but I don't want to. It's not just me who has to ask the question. I am talking loud. I am taking the risk. I am coming up forth to empower you, the power I have to question. Realize it's your right to question.
Well, last question for me is that, is just asking questions enough to make a change?
No. Just asking is not just throwing a stone. Know the issues. You realize what is the solution. Ask for it. Don't wait for them to give you promises. It's over. Don't buy promised toothpaste anymore. These are all promised toothpastes. They are only selling you dreams. So next time when you ask a question, please be aware of the issues you are facing. Know what is disturbing you. Know what is making you helpless. Know the truth and ask the question. Only then the question will have something productive about it.
Thank you everyone for joining us. We'll be coming with more updates as Prakash Raj travels to the state campaigning. Just asking.